welcome to Mangum News. I'm your host, Elijah Mangum. This week, we'll be discussing new national vaccine mandates, two arrested in a Flowood police chase into Pearl, my review of What If Episode 5, and the 20th anniversary of the 9/11 attacks. Without further ado, let's begin. On Thursday, President Joe Biden announced new rules from the Department of Labor mandating that all employers with 100 or more employees to be fully vaccinated or to be subject to weekly testing. Speaking at the White House, Biden sharply criticized the tens of millions of Americans who have yet to be vaccinated, despite months of availability and incentives. Many governors have criticized the order, some even posing legal battles against it, including Governor Tate Reeves of Mississippi, Ron DeSantis of Florida, Kristi Noem of South Dakota, and more. Flowood police attempted to stop a vehicle for multiple traffic violations. The subject refused to stop. Officers continued to attempt pulling the vehicle over. In the process, the subject rammed into a Flowood police unit and continued towards Pearl. Multiple jurisdictions along the Pearl Police and the Rankin County Sheriff's Department assisted. The subject was later taken into custody inside the city limits of Pearl, after also damaging another Flowood police and Pearl police unit. The subjects have been identified as Liberian Manuel and Larkia Wolf. Manuel is charged with fleeing, aggravated assault on a police officer, and possession of a firearm by a convicted felon. Wolf is being charged with the possession of a firearm by a convicted felon. Subjects are both held in the Rankin County Jail with no bond. This week's episode of What If asked the question, what if some of the Avengers in the world became zombies? The episode succeeds with beautiful animation and solid sequences of horror, but suffers from a convoluted story. Twenty years ago today was September 11, 2001, the worst terrorist attack in the history of the United States. Let's look back at the past 20 years that have changed the nation and the world as a whole. On the morning of September 11, 2001, four planes were hijacked in a coordinated effort by an Islamic terrorist group known as Al-Qaeda. The first plane crashed into the North Tower of the World Trade Center. Just minutes later, the second plane crashed into the South Tower. Less than 2 hours of the attacks, both towers collapsed, causing multiple casualties, injuries, and damages on the ground in New York City. Unfortunately, that was not the end, as the third plane hit the headquarters of the U.S. military, the Pentagon, resulting in the partial collapse of the building's side. The final plane was set for Washington, D.C., most likely heading to either the White House or the Capitol building. However, passengers were able to take control of the plane, crashing it into a field in Pennsylvania, killing everyone on board. The Bush administration responded by invading Afghanistan and overthrowing the Taliban-controlled government, which allied with Al-Qaeda. In 2003, the U.S. had invaded Iraq and overthrew their president, Saddam Hussein. After President Bush claimed that they had weapons of mass destruction, but it was later revealed that they didn't. Shortly after, President Bush declared mission accomplished, but they stayed in Afghanistan and Iraq to nation build. While President Bush won re-election against Senator John Kerry in 2004, his popularity plummeted in his second term as the Iraq War got worse and the Great Recession began at home. In 2008, Senator Barack Obama defeated Senator John McCain, becoming the first black president of the United States. During his term in 2011, the U.S. finally found and assassinated Osama bin Laden, the man responsible for organizing the 9/11 attacks. In 2012, the members of an Islamic terrorist group attacked two U.S. government officials in Benghazi, Libya, resulting in the deaths of U.S. foreign diplomats. President Barack Obama, Secretary of State Hillary Clinton, and National Security Advisor Susan Rice received many accusations and criticisms of their involvement and response to the attack. Despite this, President Barack Obama won re-election, defeating former Massachusetts Governor Mitt Romney in 2012. Towards the end of his second term, a new terrorist organization known as ISIS emerged, committing attacks both at home and abroad. This, along with other factors, led to businessman and reality TV star Donald Trump's upset victory against former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton in 2016. President Trump's biggest victory in the war was in the assassination of ISIS leader al-Baghdadi in 2019. President Trump lost re-election to former Vice President Joe Biden in 2020. President Biden was determined to finally bring an end to the war in Afghanistan. As troops began to withdraw, the Taliban began to re-seize control of Afghanistan city by city. When they seized full control, the Taliban set a deadline of August 31st, 2021 for the U.S. to fully withdraw. President Biden fully withdrew at the expense of American citizens and equipment still left abandoned in Afghanistan. 20 years later, the fallout of 9/11 has come full circle, and it will never be forgotten. Even to this day, we still mourn the thousands of Americans who were killed that day, and are forever grateful for the sacrifices of the first responders. That's all we have for this week. Make sure to like, share, and subscribe on YouTube and Facebook. Thanks for watching, and we'll see y'all Sunday. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land.